Michael McPhie, CEO and President of Prize Mining. Thank you so much for joining us here
in
Geneva.
Nice to be here.
Talking copper prices, obviously, with you today. How much is dependent on a recovery in China to get the copper price moving here again?
Well, copper is the most traded commodity in the world, bar none. And I kind of think of it as sort of the nervous system of modern society. I mean, everything we do, the electrification from electric cars through to the appliances we use, our cell phones, everything, it all runs on electricity, which is delivered by copper. And so the medium, long term, even the near term trend for copper is good. We're going to get these short term variations when there's trade tensions between China and America, but that'll resolve itself ultimately, and copper is needed in every aspect of modern society.
So outside of China, which would be the second largest country requiring copper right now?
Well, probably India, but really any industrializing nation in the world. You think about every electrical wire, every electrical motor, it all is copper as its primary component.
And yeah, I found that interesting that in electrical vehicles actually demand four times more copper than a regular.
The whole motor is copper. Everybody talks about batteries, but that's the one piece that provides it. But everything else is either steel on the outside or copper running the engine. So
talking prize mining now, your copper project focused in Mexico.
Yep.
Bob Archer, who a lot of our viewers will know from Great Panther fame, involved in the project.
Yeah.
How did you guys meet, and how did this come about?
So I took over as CEO of the company in February, and we approached Bob. He's got 20 years of experience in Mexico. We're up in northeastern Mexico in Coahuila State, safe part. It's where all the Daimler, Chrysler, and F-150 plants are, a big, big industrial area. And we have this fantastic project with grade, with scale, with size, and something we think is pretty special. And Bob, I think, bought into that same sort of thesis that we had. And so he joined our board in March, and he's the head of our technical committee and the QP on the project. And so him and I are working. We're here in Zurich together, or in Geneva together, and working on this, trying to make this a real success.
So let's talk about the size of the deposit. Yeah. How much copper do you think is there?
Well, there's lots. I mean, we have 180 square kilometers. It's a very interesting because it's called a stratabound deposit. So if you can imagine kind of like a sandwich that runs for 50 kilometers along, where you've got the bread on the top and on the bottom, and you've got the copper through the middle. And the trend of this, there's 35 major showings over 50 kilometers. The grades are anywhere between 1 and 5% copper, which by global standards is great. And it's very similar to the big copper deposits that have mined for hundreds of years in Poland. They're known as Kupferschiefer type deposits. So if you can just imagine this landscape of this big blue and green band that runs for kilometers, that's what we have. We're drilling it now. Our first drilling results just came out this week, and we're going to have constant news flow of these great areas for weeks and weeks ahead. So we're very excited.
I wish you luck with the project. Thanks so much
for
talking to us here.
Very nice talking.
Thanks so much.